everyone. Welcome to today's webinar session. So this is Monica here from Ayush Kerava. I'll be the moderator for today's webinar. Hoping to have more participants to join shortly. So as we all know, COVID has changed the world as we knew it in 2020. We went from 0 to 100 in seconds and the whole world came to complete standstill. In many parts of the world, it still is. So along the timeline, health hazards become a major threat to humankind. To create a healthy future, we took the responsibility of boosting up health with traditional medicine, following in the footsteps of our ancestors. So our Ayush Kerava is an initiative to bring back the precious traditional medicine into our lives to build a healthy environment. We stepped into online consultation by joining hands with experienced doctors from various streams like Ayurveda, Yoga, Siddha, Yunani, Homeopathy and Naturopathy. We serve wholeheartedly to establish awareness about the ancient medicinal methods and its benefits to the people. Moving forward, we help people get benefited through the traditional medicine by providing online consultation to nook and every corner of the world. So this webinar is a milestone in our Ayush Kerava journey to educate about the Parkinson's disease. Without any further delay, let me introduce our chief guest and speaker, Dr. K.V. Vijit, who has strong roots in the field of Ayurvedic medicine. Dr. K.V. Vijit is the torch bearer of the fourth generation noble traditional Ayurveda family, and hence Dr. K.V. Vijayan Institute of Ayurvedic Medicine and Science in Palakkad, Kerala. With an experience of more than 15 years, he now runs a manufacturing unit, hospital and more than 25 direct Ayurveda clinics and Mitra Ayurspas in Kerala and Tamil Nadu, Goa. So let us take this wonderful opportunity to know more about Parkinson's disease. Over to you, doctor.
Thank you, Monica, for the wonderful introduction. Thank you and very good afternoon all.
Very good afternoon, doctor.
Yeah, Monica. So I will start my screen sharing.
Sure.
Please, the host has disabled the participant for screen sharing. Please make me co-host. Then only I can share my screen.
I'm just
doing the doctor. Thank you. So, shall we start or are we expecting anybody to join?
They will be joining, doctor. You can go ahead.
Thank you. Thank you, Monica.
Thanks, doctor.
So, once again, good evening all. Welcome to this webinar session conducted by Ayush Kerava along with me, Dr. K.V. Vijayan, Institute of Ayurveda Medical Science, Private Limited. Today, we are discussing about Parkinson's Viam's approach. So let us discuss what is Parkinson's disease initially. Parkinson's disease is a progressive degenerative disorder of the central nervous system affecting the motor and cognitive functions. You all know brain has mainly two functions, that is motor function and cognitive function. So motor function means any movement in our body will comes under the motor, and the cognitive functions means any functions of our mind related to mind will come under cognitive function. So Parkinson's is a progressive degenerative disorder of the central nervous system affecting the motor and cognitive functions. Are we at risk? Do you think, are we at risk? Well, approximately 1% of people globally above 60 years of age suffer from Parkinson's. And recent observations shows growing number of younger people are being diagnosed with Parkinson's. Younger people means younger than 50 years of age are being diagnosed with Parkinson's or neurodegenerative diseases related to Parkinson's disease. As we all know, there is no preventive method for Parkinson's. So let all be safe. How Parkinson's? Progressive degeneration. I repeat, progressive degeneration. That means the degeneration will occur and that degeneration will progress. That is known as the progressive degeneration of dopamine producing cells. Dopamine is a chemical constituent produced in the human brain. Like there is somebody, you may hear about the adrenaline. Like adrenaline, this dopamine is another one of the chemical constituent generated from brain, especially from substantia nigra. That is, substantia nigra is a region of the midbrain. So dropping down of the dopamine levels develop cardinal symptoms. Cardinal symptoms means the most important symptom, like tremor. Tremor means shaking of hands or legs or entire body or head. Bradykinesia. Bradykinesia means slowness of movement, slowness of walking, and postural instability, the posture of our body. Let's see what are the causes of Parkinson's. Most of the Parkinson disease are diagnosed as idiopathic, IPD, idiopathic Parkinson disease. So what does this idiopathic means? Idiopathic means without any reason, the patient will diagnose as Parkinson's disease. That is known as idiopathic. And hereditary, next is hereditary. Hereditary means if parents or grandparents or close relatives will have any type of neurodegenerative diseases, especially dear participants, can you please mute yourself? Otherwise, it will be disturbance for the other participants. Dear host, dear Monica, are you there? Hello, Monica.
Yes, doctor, I'm here.
Yeah, I'm muting all the participants, okay?
Please. Sure, sir.
Okay. So, hereditary. I repeat, hereditary. That means the parents or grandparents or close relatives, is anybody will have this Parkinson disease or any neurodegenerative disease like stroke, paralysis, dementia, Alzheimer's, mentally retarded, they have the chance of getting Parkinson disease more compared to other. The next is the most important, drug induced. If anybody have, even in childhood, if they have any seizures or epilepsy history, they may have to take long-term medications like 2 year or 3 year or more than that. And if somebody will have the asthma problems, the lung related problems, if somebody will have the gut related problems, and they are taking medicines for more than minimum of 1 year or more than that, they have a chance of Parkinson's disease later, and that is known as drug induced Parkinson's disease. The next is traumatic. Road traffic accidents, RTA, or hitting our head on a hard surface. These may lead to Parkinson's disease, and that come under traumatic. And they are also known as vascular Parkinson's. Next is chemical interactions. Anybody will have some interaction with chemical, poisonous substances, fertilizers, and in high altitude, those people will have the risk of having Parkinson's disease, and it will diagnose as chemical interactive Parkinson's disease. And the last but not least is accelerated aging, which there is no need of explanation for this accelerated aging. what will be the signs and symptoms of Parkinson's? We can classify them into three. Simply, we can classify them into three: the motor, the neuropsychiatric, and the others. The motor I had mentioned earlier. The motor means anything related, any movement happen in our body will come under the motor functions. And anything related to our mind will come under cognitive or neuropsychiatric, and others means general. These motor symptoms, we can classify these motor symptoms as primary symptoms and secondary symptoms. So primary symptoms will come under this tremor. That is the most important or most common symptom of Parkinson's. And the tremor are of different types. The rust tremor, kinetic tremor, and pill rolling tremor. The rust tremor means if the patient is keeping rest or staying in a bed or staying in a chair and they are not moving and they are watching TV, reading newspapers, suddenly the hands will shake like this. That is known as rust tremor. The kinetic tremor means the patient will not have tremor at all. But if he's going to do some actions while taking the mobile phone, while taking the remote, while to start writing, then the patient will have that kinetic tremor. At that time, the tremor will start, and that is known as kinetic tremor. And the pill rolling tremor, that means like this, like with two fingers, the tremor will be there. And the next is rigidity or stiffness of muscles, either in one side or two side or in lower limbs or in upper limbs or whole body. Bradykinesia. Bradykinesia means slowness of movement. Mainly slowness of movement means when we start walking, the patient will have the capacity to start walking in a normal speed. Gradually, the speed of the walking or gait will decrease, and that is known as bradykinesia. Next is postural instability. I think there is no need of explanation. You can look at to that picture. You can easily identify what postural instability is. And the secondary symptom of motor symptoms include frozen movements, akinesia. This akinesia is followed by earlier mentioned bradykinesia. Initially, the patient can able to start walking freely. Then the patient walking will get slow. And finally, the patient can't able to walk. That is known as akinesia or frozen movements. Next is micrographia. Micrographia means if the patient start writing, in the initial stage the writing will be normal, gradually the writing will become very small. That is known as micrographia. Next is masked face. Masked face means there will be no expressions in the face of the patient. Next is dystonic movements. Dystonic movement means abnormal muscle movements. The tremor will be very low, but the dystonic movements will be very, very large movements will be there in dystonic movements. Next is stopped posture, that we can correlate with the postural instability I mentioned earlier. Next is dysphagia. Dysphagia means difficulty to swallow the food. While swallowing the food, especially volume items, that means volume means tea, coffee, water, the patient will have choking. That is known as dysphagia. And dysarthria. Dysarthria means difficulty to speak. That is known as dysarthria. And coming to neuropsychiatric symptoms, depression, anxiety, apathy, psychosis. These are the main neuropsychiatric symptoms we seen in a Parkinson's disease patient. These come under the cognitive functions. The other symptoms: sleep disturbances, daytime drowsiness because of taking heavy dose of medicine, fearful dreams, hallucinations, loud noises during sleep. These three comes under the sleep disturbances. The patient will have fearful dreams. He is going to hit an accident, he is going to meet an accident, or somebody is going to attack him. That is a fearful dream. Hallucinations means he will speak very loudly, but it will not be very clear. Loud noises during sleep. then monotonous soft sound. There will be a single sound. The patient will try to speak, but a single sound will be there. That is known as monotonous sound. And other symptoms continues: urinary incontinence, hypotension, sexual problems, constipation, fatigue, aches and pains in body, which these aches and pains, they can't define exactly what they're feeling. So worries in Parkinson's. Okay, frequent fall means, I had already mentioned, there will be walking difficulty will be there, imbalance during walk will be there. So just because of that imbalance, the patient will have frequent falls. The next is incapacitation. The patient will have very low self-confidence or very, very low self-esteem. Depressions and dementia, no need of explanation. Then aspiration. That aspiration is related to dysphagia I mentioned in the earlier slide, because the patient will have difficulty to swallow the problems and there is a chance of entering the food particles into the lungs. Then unusual fear, confusions, difficulty to take a decision, and bruxism. Bruxism means teethening, teeth from the sound. That is known as bruxism. So many worries are there, but I'm mentioning only some of the worries just because of the time constraint. What are the investigation methods available nowadays for this Parkinson? Generally, CT scan, MRI scan, PET scan, and the most effective scanning in Parkinson disease is TRODAT scan, that is levodopa direct challenge test. Now I will be detailing about the uniqueness and success stories of Parkinson disease in my clinical experience at Dr. K.V. Vijayan Institute of Ayurveda Medical Science Private Limited. Who are we? Vyams. Dr. K.V. Vijayan Institute of Ayurveda Medical Science was founded in 1972 as a Vaidyashala, which means traditional Ayurveda health clinic. We have the legacy of a rich and unique heritage of healthcare tradition spanning four generations, which follows Ayurvedic practices and disciplines. Vyams started as a Vaidyashala, later advanced as a clinic, and established as a full-fledged hospital facility. Simultaneously, in 1996, we extended our hands to an in-house GMP and ISO certified pharmaceutical enterprise, KV's Pharmaceuticals, one of the leading manufacturers of Ayurvedic medicines in Kerala. Our desire to assure well-being for the society has led to Mitra Ayur Spa in 2018, another VAMS affiliate, introducing more patients to human life. We are all spreading our wings into VAMS Academy, a new world of Ayurvedic education. So, in Parkinson's, the conception of Parkinson's disease as Kambavada, Ayurveda envisions the human body as a congregation of three basic humors, namely Vata, Pitta, and Kapha. These three entities, that is the Vata, Pitta, and Kapha, help in body functioning as per Tridosha theory in Ayurveda. Vata is the entity which controls and coordinates our body functions, such as movements and thought process. Aggravation of certain qualities of Vata result in tremors, imbalance, cognitive impairment, etc. Thus, correlate Parkinson's to such an exaggerated condition of Vata called Kambavada. So what is Kambavada in Ayurveda? Karapada tale kambe deha bremana dukkide nidra bango madikshena kambavada selakshana. This is a quotation from Basavarajiyam, 6th chapter, written in 18th century by Acharya Basavaraju. So what we have to understand from this statement is this Kambavada, that is closely related to Parkinson's disease, is mentioned in Ayurveda text even in 18th century. So let's translate that Sanskrit sloga into English. Shivering of palm and sole, vertigo, severe grief, loss of sleep, reduced confidence are the symptoms of Kambavada. Let's see the clinical features. We had already discussed the clinical features. Tremors in hands and legs, that is Kamba. Tremor means Kamba. Vertigo, we mentioned as imbalance. Loss of sleep, Nidra Bhangam. That is the Ayurvedic term for the loss of sleep. Dementia, Stamba, which means rigidity. Sheshtahani, which means slowness of movement. Vinamana, flexed posture. Vak Vikriti, that is speech disorders, we mention it as dysarthria. Change in facial expression, mentioned as masked face. Then voice and speech change, that is again dysarthria. Sleep disorder, sexual dysfunction, seborrhea, muscular atrophy, drooling. These are some of the clinical features mentioned in Ayurvedic classics text. Our objective to manage Parkinson's disease or Kambavada: arrest further degeneration by taking the internal medicines or doing the external therapies, which I am going to explain in the later slides. The main objective is to arrest further degeneration of brain cells, especially in substantia nigra. If we arrest further degeneration of the brain cells, definitely longevity will be there. Betterment in quality of life, that is daily activities, and regeneration of cells in possible cases. That means if the patient is above 60 years of age, it will be very difficult for the regeneration of the brain cells. But we had mentioned in the first slide that younger people are having this Parkinson even below 50 years of age. In those cases, it will be hard possible for the regeneration of the cells. That's what I meant, impossible cases. The uniqueness of VAMS treatment in Parkinson's disease or Kambavada: authenticity in medicines. I had mentioned we have our own medicine manufacturing unit, which help us to make tailor-made herbal combinations. Yes, it is possible because of the own medicine manufacturing unit. Even I can produce in a very small quantity for a single patient. It is possible, and I'm following that method. Then next is personalized customization. The therapies, the Panchakarma therapies or the Ayurveda therapies, are tailored to suit each patient and ailments. Before we start the treatment, I will fix a treatment protocol only after personalized consultation. The next is the most important key factor in the uniqueness of VAMS: the integration. At VAMS, traditional and customized Ayurvedic treatment is incorporated with allied healthcare techniques, with yoga, physiotherapy, psychology, audiology, speech therapy and nutrition and dietetics. Faultless approach. We keep 360 degree focus on patients and their symptoms, whereby which we can also manage all related conditions. We have a legacy, a rich and splendid healthcare tradition spanning four generations. Our methodology in the treatment of Parkinson's or Kampavada, analysis, differential diagnosis, followed by diagnosis. Then we will define the treatment protocol. I mentioned integration of traditional and customized Ayurvedic treatment with allied healthcare techniques such as physiotherapy, psychology, audiology, speech therapy, dietetics, yoga, and meditation. Customized herbal combinations to have an optimum result. Analysis. Darsana sparshana prashne parikshedha cha rogina rogam nidana pragrupa lakshanopasayatibi. Darsana, visual analysis. Sparshana, physical analysis. Prashna, question and answer session or interactive session. Then we will go to investigations. So visual analysis means, if I can see the patient will have tremor in both hands, or the patient will have tremor the whole body, and the patient is having a postural instability as well. So I can identify visually and physically, even I can touch. The physical analysis is good for knowing the range of stiffness and rigidity. Interactive session, mainly for taking his history and to analyze whether he is having any dysarthria problems, speech difficulties. Finally, the investigations. If we have discussed some investigation methods like MRI, then trodad scan, etc. So if anything is mentioned clearly in these investigations, it is very easily for the treatment protocol development. Next is differential diagnosis. This is nowadays, this is very important. Why? Nowadays, this Parkinson's disease has become an umbrella term. Any neurodegenerative disease, they will name it as Parkinson's disease or PD, simply PD, Parkinson's. No. Parkinson's disease is having a lot of signs and symptoms. See, we will take the Parkinsonism. Parkinsonism means the patient will have one or two or some symptoms of typical Parkinson's disease, but it will not be typical Parkinson's disease. It will be typical Parkinson's disease only if the patient will have the cardinal symptoms which I had mentioned earlier. Alzheimer's, you already know. We'll take the PSP. PSP means progressive supranuclear palsy. In Parkinson, I had already mentioned the brain cells, the substantia nigra cells get degenerated. And as a result of that, dopamine production will be very low. But in PSP, the supranuclear cells or the brain cells in the supranuclear area will get degenerated. And the PSP patient will not be having any tremor, but we can easily identify the PSP patient. How? The eye movements will be restricted for the PSP patients. The speech difficulties will be more. Mask face will be there. And the PSP patient will have the imbalance only to backside. But in Parkinson patient, the patient will have the imbalance to all sides. Then motor neuron diseases, MSA, multiple system atrophy. that is cerebrum and cerebellum is included, then we can say it is a MSA. OPCA, oligopondocerebellar atrophy. Speech difficulties will be there in OPCA. Tremor will be very low. Neck stiffness will be more. Then ataxias. Ataxia means atrophy, strengthening of the brain. Writer's cramp. Writer's cramp means the patient will have the difficulty to write, and the patient will have the tremor only when he is intended to write. That is not Parkinson. And dystonia. Dystonia is mainly because of high dosage of medicines for Parkinson disease, and that mainly to dystonia. Dystonia means abnormal muscle movements. And finally, next to diagnosis. If the three cardinal symptoms confirms, that is uncontrolled tremor, postural deformity, bradykinesia, if the three symptoms will be there in the patient, we can diagnose it as a typical Parkinson's disease. Otherwise, we must go through the differential diagnosis and we have to find the root cause. So, Unified Parkinson's disease rating scale, we are following that, and we will grade 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 0 means the tremor. If there is no tremor, we will grade it as 0. And the patient will have the tremor all over the body all time, then we will rate it as 4. If the patient is having tremor on only one hand, then we will rate it as 1. If the patient will have tremor on both hands or tremor on one side of the body, then we will rate it as 2. Like that, we will rate each and every symptom of Parkinson's disease, or not only Parkinson's disease, any neurodegenerative diseases. Finally, how we define the treatment protocol, the most important. The treatment protocol is individualized as per the condition and nature of the patient and the progression of the disease. Key treatment protocol includes internal medications, external therapies, that is Panchakarma treatment, Ayurveda Panchakarma treatment, and allied healthcare techniques. Internal medicines aimed at improving nerve and muscle strength, cognitive ability, as well as regeneration of atrophied cells. External therapies, that is Panchakarma therapy, definitely it will help to improve muscle strength, tone and bulk, as well as improving the cognitive functions. Allied healthcare techniques, we are going to discuss it in detail. Integration of physiotherapy. Regular physical exercise with or without physical therapy can be beneficial to maintain and improve mobility, flexibility, strength, gait, and quality of life. Physiotherapy can help with the movement and balance problems in Parkinson's disease. Integration of psychology in the treatment protocol of Kambavata. Our psychologists assess individuals to diagnose their mental, emotional, and behavioral disorders, and then treat them using a variety of techniques, including cognitive behavioral therapy, commonly known as CBT. Integration of ASLP, audiology and speech language pathology. ASLP specialist work to assess, diagnose, prevent and treat speech, language, social communication, cognitive communication and swallowing disorders. They are trained to diagnose, manage and treat hearing or imbalance problems. That is, imbalance problem means vertigo as well. Integration of nutrition and dietetics. dietitian can provide a nutritional assessment, which includes an evaluation of the individual's food and nutrient intake, their lifestyle, and their medical history. Nutritional assessments performed routinely as the treatment progresses, their advance contributes to improve the quality of life. This is very important in the treatment of Parkinson's or Kambavada. Why? Because of this neurodegeneration, the food what you are taking will not absorb properly. And as a result of that, the hemoglobin level, the vitamin B12, vitamin D, everything will be very low in almost all patients. So the nutrition plays a key role in the treatment protocol. Yoga, the system India given to the whole world, the holistic approach. The yoga and meditation can improve movement, cognitive and behavioral problems. More than being a mere exercise regimen, yoga aims to coordinate bodily functions with that of the mind. Whereas yoga techniques helps in maintaining peace, confidence and happiness to the mind, while helping to increase flexibility, reduced muscle spasms and ultimately leading to an improved quality of life. Mindful meditation can be used to relax and focus on breathing or negative emotions and thought. So, mitigation or management is very important when we are discussing about a treatment protocol or about a disease. Initially, let's see what are the common methods right now we are following. Prescribed medications, physical therapy, occupational therapy, surgical treatment options, that is deep brain stimulation therapy or DBS, over-the-counter and complementary therapies, exercise, term center physical therapy, and clinical trials. How Vyams method is different than common method, or the Vyams mitigation or management of Parkinson's or Kambavada? Alleviation of exaggerated doshas with customized internal medications or formulations, and cleansing the body with Panchakarma therapies. Improving the core muscular functioning and imbalance through physiotherapy. Psychology counseling assesses and treats emotional, cognitive, and behavioral problems. SLP specialists assess and treat persons' speech, language, and hearing problems. Rekindling the vigor of the body and mind through yoga and meditation. Definitely, the nutritionist plays a key role in the Vyams method. So, why I am integrating all this? Because the patient, in the symptoms we had discussed, the patient will have stiffness and rigidity. This stiffness and rigidity we can overcome with the physiotherapy department. The patient will have dysphagia, difficulty to swallow and difficulty to speech, and imbalance problem, which we can overcome with the help of an ASLP. The patient will have higher mental tension, anxiety, emotions, anger, depression, mood swings, sleep disturbances, etc. These problems we can overcome with the psychology department or psychologist. And I mentioned the vitamin D deficiency, less hemoglobin level, vitamin B12 level. This we can overcome or turn around with the nutritionist help. And yoga and meditation finally. I would like to conclude this session because we are running out of time. Parkinson's disease is a disorder with no established cure. Anyway, the healthcare are running behind for a sure shot result in the laboratories, and so many researchers are going on across the globe. Ayurveda has shown that it has a better success rate than other systems of medicine while dealing with any degenerative disorders. Why? Because we people, the Ayurveda people, the Ayurveda are not providing any medicines or any treatment to the symptoms. We are treating the root cause. That's why we are getting excellent results in any neurodegenerative disorders. Similarly, it has considerable potential in dealing with neurodegenerative disorders is yet to be properly explored. Myself and my team are behind that. Advance, we treat and document each of these cases with the ultimate aim to invite attention towards Ayurveda possibilities. Continuous learning and research process to have an ultimate solution for Parkinson's. Finally, today I can proudly say, yes, we can control Parkinson's. Thank you. Sarve Samdhini Ramaya, let all be healthy. And I would like to thank Team Ayush Carever, especially special thanks to Vinod, Monica, and the team Vyams, Dr. Nidhu Esjit, Dr. Sharanya, Dr. Abhijit, the designing team, the support team, not but the least, the operations director, Mr. Ritesh Manoharan. Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you, doctor.
Dear participants, you can ask any questions and you can put that questions in the chat box so I can read one by one and I can answer that. Thank you. Thank you, Monica. Over to you.
Thank you so much, doctor. That's really a wonderful presentation. And I hope really everyone of here gained knowledge about Parkinson's disease by you. So some of them started asking some questions in the chat, doctor. You can just address to that. Doctor, we couldn't hear you.
Yes, yes. Naveen Gadam has asked, please explain again about Unified Parkinson Rating Scale. Actually, that Unified Parkinson Rating Scale is provided by James Parkinson Society, which is in UK. They had a set of questions like the symptoms, the tremor, rigidity, then the walking difficulties, sleep disturbances, so and so. So we will ask the patient if you have tremor. If the patient is not having any tremor, we will put a zero mark. And the patient have tremor all over the body, then we will give the 4 points. So totally there will be 199 points in that Unified Parkinson Rating Scale. So if the patient comes in January, we will take that Parkinson Rating Scale. And after 2 months or 3 months or even after 6 months of treatment, we will again take that Parkinson rating. And if we are getting at that time, if we are getting like 120, there is a difference of 80 points. So we can easily understand that he is getting a good betterment of life. That is the thing. And the next question.
Where is the next question? 1 second.
He is an young doctor. Earlier he studied because hands shake. He is an MB Parkinson, 25 pages book. Nowadays he became a department in neurology. Monica, I can't understand the question.
I don't think that's in a question, doctor. He just explained something about the book. We can pass on to the next one.
Dr. Surya Narayanan. Okay. Mr. J. Dilip Kumar has asked, what is the difference between paralysis and Parkinson's disease? Paralysis means impairment, or we will be completely immobile. That is paralysis. And Parkinson's disease, it is a neurodegenerative disorder, and this paralysis happens suddenly because of an infarct in the brain, like that. Can Ashwagandha Kapikachu is a choice in the disease? Definitely yes, definitely yes. Because Kapikachu is the base of the dopamine, or the modern medicine are prescribing Sindopa plus, like that. And the base of the Sindopa plus and everything is Kapikachu. And Ashwagandha is also a Nervine tonic. Definitely it plays, the both medicines will plays a key role. And these both medicines I am providing to my patients. Sir, Arishtams and Brahmi, how useful in PD? I never give Arishtas because Dr. Surya Narayan, I think he's a doctor. As by my knowledge, there is a blood-brain barrier in our brain. This blood-brain barrier will absorb only three items. One is alcohol, one is heavy metals, and the last is fat molecules. So I prefer to give any neurodegenerative medicine in the form of Sneha. Sneha means the fat molecules like medicated Girdha, medicated oil, etc. The Arishta is definitely plays a key role, but Arishta and Asava will have a self-fermented alcohol, which is supposed to, which will damage the nerve cells very slowly. So I didn't prescribe Arishta. And Brahmi, definitely Brahmi is useful, no doubt about that. Half body Parkinson, how we treat? Half body Parkinson means, I think you are talking about hemi Parkinson disease. That is tremor on one side of the body, like hemiplegia. The patient will have tremor and stiffness, rigidity in one part of the body. The same protocol we will apply. There is no any other different protocol for that. What precautions to be taken by people who have a family history of Parkinson? Honestly speaking, there is no prevention for this Parkinson disease. Even I had mentioned so many signs and symptoms in my presentation. If you have any small signs or symptoms from that list, better you consult a doctor. As early we can diagnose, as early we can identify this disease, it is very easy to treat. That is the thing. Again, Dr. Surya Narayan, can treat on mastishka or general regeneration? Yeah, regeneration will be there. Okay, and vice versa. If we do the regeneration, the mastishka will also get treated. Essential tremor grade 1 or grade 2 related to Parkinson's? Essential tremor is not Parkinson's. Actually, tremor is one of the symptoms of Parkinson's. Essential tremor is another disease profile. It is not Parkinson's. Stammer is a symptom of PD. Yes, definitely. Stammering is a symptom in Parkinson's disease. No doubt about that. If a pregnant woman is earlier PD, can't, if a pregnant woman is ALPD, can I think Monica, can you please ask what he meant? Or can you Dr. Surya Narayan, can you please unmute and ask?
Dr. Surya Narayan, can you please unmute yourself and ask your question directly?
Yeah, I unmuted already.
Yes, doctor, please go ahead.
Hi, doctor, good evening.
Doctor, just to remind me that question I posted already in the chat box.
The last question I didn't understand. If a pregnant woman is earlier PD, can we treat her? That is your question.
Because of in the 25 years of, below 25 years of a woman having the tremor and the symptoms of PD, okay. Can we go for treatment?
Definitely we can treat, no problem. Because if she is below 25 years, there will be definitely a root cause will be there. We have to find out that root cause. Then our treatment will be very effective and very easy.
Sir, cost in the cost badda is related in this particular case.
What it is?
Cost badda. Cost constipation.
Yeah, constipation, definitely. That is one of the very, very early symptoms of Parkinson. See, why... I will explain, give me one moment. Why constipation is one of the main symptoms of Parkinson's disease? As you all know, our intestines, large intestines, small intestines, that is muscular movement will be there. So I had mentioned that this is a progressive degenerative neuromuscular disorder. Because of this new, this muscular degeneration, the bowel movements will be very low. So as a part of that, because of this low bowel movements, the constipation will be there for the patient. That is the thing.
Sir, in pitta predominant cases, the tremor will arise, then what?
Pitta predominant, especially vada predominant cases will be more preferable in Parkinson's. Pitta predominant will be there, but vada is...
adjoined.
You mean you are asking for a treatment protocol of this pitta predominant Parkinson?
Pitta predominant Parkinson's.
What treatment? That is it. Your question is not... Okay.
Yeah.
Virajanam.
Okay.
Especially Nitya Virajana is very effective.
Nitya Virajana, for we go for Trifala or any other these things?
Snehana. So any Snehana medicines. Aranda.
Tivrut also.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, doctor.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir.
Okay.
Okay. Welcome, sir. Okay. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Monica?
Cancer, Aswata Rishpro is useful in Parkinson's?
Who's speaking? Are you a doctor?
Yes.
Okay, see, I had already mentioned that I'm not promoting any Arishtas or Asavas in the treatment of Parkinson's. Definitely, Saraswata Arishta is a brain tone. We can think about that, but I'm not following that.
Okay, sir, okay.
Because our Acharyas has mentioned so many medicines, especially in the Sneha Prayogas.
Yes, sir, thank you, sir.
Our Acharyas mentioned all brain tones as made as Snehana Prayogas.
Anybody else would like to clarify something related to the Parkinson's disease? Please post your questions.
Please.
Yeah. Hi, doctor. This is Suresh. And it's early morning. My question is, levodopa drug challenge you mentioned is one of the time which you...
Levodopa test, rodent test. Yes.
What is it? Are you able to elaborate, please?
Actually, we will inject a dye. And we will, how can I explain? Like, you familiar about the barium meal?
Barium meal.
Yeah, similarly for this this rodent scan, a dye will be injected and we will take the images and we will assess how much dopamine loss will be there. Actually, it's just an investigation, not a treatment protocol. We will analyze, okay, this much is the difference of the dopamine level. That's all.
Okay, appreciate it.
Is there any other questions?
There is. Dear sir, this is Rajan Saha from Dhaka, Bangladesh. I'm really happy to be part of your wonderful presentation concerning Ayurveda treatment in our country. People mostly concerned about prompt solution, that is allopathy treatment. After hearing your presentation, I observed that Ayurveda treatment can be best solution in today's new normal days due to COVID-19, because people are now just moving nowadays. I think this treatment should converse widely in our country. In this regard, what would be your thoughts? In India, especially in Kerala, so many doctors are practicing, but I am concentrating into this Parkinson, and we have developed a unique treatment protocol, and I'm having patients from Bangladesh also. Anywhere across the globe we can do this, no problem. If the law allows in each and every country, we can follow this. Or we can do this.
Doctor, is Kampavata related to Parkinson's disease?
Yes, I had already mentioned that in my slides.
Okay. Doctor, with your permission, can we conclude this session? Doctor Vijay?
Yes.
Can we conclude the session?
I heard it is Vidya. That's why.
Okay.
Yeah, definitely we can conclude. If there is no other question, we can conclude it.
Great. So at this very moment, Ayushcare is really proud to host such a great webinar and thanking you for sharing your precious knowledge with us, Doctor. So we at Ayushcare are constantly working in creating an impact on the lives of the people. So everyone, feel free to reach out to us through our website. I have already mentioned all the details. Get healed through Ayush method of medicine without any side effects. So the recorded version of this webinar will be available at the YouTube forever. So thank you so much, Doctor. Thank you for your precious time.
Thank you. Good day, all. Bye.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you for all the participation. And thank you so much once again.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you, Doctor.